Hello again. We have more news regarding the council update and Halloween update today. I haven't read this yet, so we're going to do that together right now. Welcome back. We've got some news for you. Council update. Dear Phasmophobia community, we'd like to express our deepest gratitude for your support and excitement for our council release. As we still try to adapt to our new remote working life after the fire incident and to establish a new office, we've encountered unforeseen challenges in adapting the game for consoles. These combined factors have affected our development timeline more than we initially anticipated. Additionally, in preparation for the PlayStation VR 2 launch, we have been diligently reviewing the game's performance and optimizing it across all maps to ensure a seamless experience for all our console players. In this regard, we had to rework Maple Lodge Camps. They had to rework Maple Lodge Campsite with a completely new layout. More information below. This decision, though time-consuming for our art team, yeah, no kidding, is essential to provide the best possible gameplay experience. While we had hoped to present you with a special launch alongside the Halloween event, the complexity of our current challenges means we need more time. I sort of saw that coming, based on what they were saying. We will keep you updated on our progress and provide a revised release date as soon as we have more information to share. We are working diligently to minimize the impact of this delay, and we want to express our sincere gratitude for your continued support. We promise when Phasmophobia arrives on consoles, it will be worth the wait. So more unfortunate news, clearly. That sucks. Council players who keep arriving to my streams and telling me about how you're excited for consoles, I'm sorry. It is what it is, I guess. Maple Lodge Campsite was the first new location added when the team was first expanded. It was made reasonably quickly and therefore had some issues regarding performance due to long sight lines, forcing the player to render many objects at once. With this in mind, CJ and our new artist, Zach, have worked together to create a brand new layout. It features a new reception building, more hiding spots, new decorative assets, and better performance across the board. The newly added reception building. Nice. Inside the storage area. Cool. Looks good. All right. I guess that's that entire update. Halloween. This year for Halloween, we'll be encouraging our ghost hunters to create a potion in their very own cauldron found in the reworked Maple Lodge campsite location. Completing the event will reward players with a new ID badge and a new trophy for their collection. Okay. They decorated the board with bats and cauldron and pumpkins. That's cool. Players will need to hunt down the recipe cards found in several other locations, then head back to the campsite and create their ghostly concoction. Additionally, both the campsite and lobby have been decorated with newly created spooky decorations for the seasonal period. Wow, that's kind of cool. The cauldron is pretty neat with on the campfire and everything. The Halloween event will launch on or around the 26th of October. Shortly after we return from TwitchCon Las Vegas, to ensure we are available to quickly hotfix any bugs that may arise during the first few days of play. Makes sense? That's it for Development Preview 15. We'll catch you with some more teasers soon. There it is. Council update. I'm sorry, guys. Eventually you'll be able to play and do cross-play with everybody, but not yet. But the campsite rework is good, and it's a step in the right direction of the ultimate goal of getting the council update up out there. And of course, if you'd like to know more about why the update was delayed to begin with, check out this video right here.